For more information on our services, visit our website at mancinilegal.com. Your first choice lawyers across Sussex.
This is the Late Night Lawyer Show with your host, Alex Mancini.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Midweek Late Night Lawyer. The date today is the 20th of May 2020. Nice, sunny, warm Britain, which is fantastic. What have we got in store for you today? Well, we've got a great friend of mine, Mr. Dominic Sacchini, the jeweler to the stars. He is going to be here today talking to everybody about his business, its effects due to this crazy pandemic, and what he is doing at the moment through the period of the pandemic. We also have, due to popular demand and due to all the messages that flooded in through social media, another song, thanks to Ali Sherlock. We'll be presenting a new piece of material from her later in the show. So what's been happening this week? It's been an interesting week. We've managed to finally get almost back to some normality with offices reopening in Haworthseath and Horsham, which is good news. Our offices are now reopened at Mancini Legal and Mulcair Jenkins with strict social distancing in place, after going through a very rigorous COVID-19 secure way of working. Some exciting stuff that's come through this week is we've actually rebranded. So you'll be able to see details of our new brand on Facebook and also on our website at mancinilegal.com. Very, very exciting, because the brand in itself, the existing brand, has been around for almost 10 years since we opened, and it's time to rebirth the brand and to make a fresh, new, bold statement that we're still here, we're stronger than ever, and we are going to push through this. So this new brand, which was launched today, and I hope everybody likes it, I'd welcome everyone's feedback, is now active across both brands of Mancini Legal and Mulcair Jenkins. So, my guest this evening, his name is Mr. Dominic Sacchini. He owns Sacchini Jewelers in Horsham. Excellent character, Mr. Sacchini. I've known him for many years. I've worked with him very closely on some projects and done quite a lot of networking with him in the years as well. So, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dominic Sacchini.
The Late Night Lawyer, Midweek Edition.
Dominic Sacchini, welcome to the show. How are you doing?
I'm great, Alex. How are you?
Very well, very well. Right, for the benefit of the listeners, give everyone a quick overview on what you do.
I'm Sacchini Jewelers. So I manufacture, I create, I design jewellery. I do diamond trading. I am a pawnbroker, a gold specialist. In fact, there's nothing I don't do within the jewellery industry.
Fantastic. How long have you been in business, Dominic?
Oh, we've been going for 17 years. I opened up June 2004. So I guess what, we're coming up 17th year now. Yeah, 17 years in the Carfax in Horsham.
Horsham, fantastic. So I hear you're a multi-award-winning jeweller. Tell me more. Tell me how you got that award. Tell me a bit about it.
Okay, so for about 5 years on the trot, we've been awarded the Retailer of the Year award. Last year was a particularly good one, because not only were we the Retailer of the Year, we also got the Southern Retailer of the Year. So that's the south coast of England, which was very good. And also I've been received a Lifetime Achievement Award. However, I couldn't quite get my head around that one, because I always thought people who get Lifetime Achievement Awards are old farts and we're wrinkles.
You're a young man.
I know, I'm quite a good-looking young fella, I am. And so apparently that was for helping local businesses getting up and running, and through experience of what we do. After going through three recessions, in case of having to reinvent the business on a regular basis.
So you talk about reinventing the business. Obviously, we're probably looming on a recession now, not far away from it. I mean, what have you done at the moment to get your business ready? What are you doing?
Well, right now we're closed. As of the 23rd of March, we had to close down with the coronavirus, as did nearly everyone in retail. There is no real idea when we're going to be opening. We would aim for the end of June. But what we've been doing is I've been working on education, because we have the Diamond Academy. Now, the Diamond Academy is a educational platform that we've been using to teach originally it was to teach people how to buy diamonds for pleasure and profit. At the end of the day, it's all about buying at trade and not about at retail, because diamonds go up around about 5% per annum, and they're a very good investment. And what I do for my clients, which other jewelers really, are not too keen on, is we sell diamonds at trade prices. And also what we've been doing is we've been putting together a course for teaching people how to successfully buy and sell precious metals. Now, you say recession coming. We definitely have a recession coming in. And during every recession through history, since the Great Depression, gold and silver prices have always gone through the roof, because investors have been investing in stocks and shares for many years, and they lose all confidence in investing in paper, basically. Now, the American market's overinflated right now. The English market, the FTSE 100, is down. And what's going to happen is, very shortly, you're going to see a huge downturn in the stock market. Now, when people get out of the stock market, they then go into something else, which is called precious metals, which is gold and silver. What does they say? Silver is for gentlemen and gold is for kings. Mm. And the last recession, we saw a huge growth up to 460% in gold. And we saw 770% growth in silver.
Wow.
So what's going to happen is these prices, these metals will start to move where people who have got out of the stock market, they're going to need to put their money into precious metals. Because don't forget, the banks at the moment are only guaranteeing £80,000 of your money, of your cash. That's what is on the government, that's what the government will guarantee for any bank account. So I think it's at £70,000 to £80,000. So those people who've got more than that sitting in an account is basically sitting there on risk. So what they would rather do is they put it in gold. The gold is going to go up. We're going to see a new record high. You've heard it here. You heard it on the Alex Mancini's cat show. And I'm going to tell you now. So, when you hear on the news and on television that gold and silver are moving through the roof, you're going to say, I remember that guy. So what I'm doing is I have created an online course which is teaching people how to successfully buy and sell precious metals. Now, this is the exciting part. How to buy and sell precious metals at 40% below spot. Now, let me tell you what spot is. Spot price on any metal is the basic, the ceiling. This is the value of what gold is today. For instance, if I say to you, spot price is $100, gold is worth $100. And I will teach you how to buy gold at 40% below spot, which gives you an inside edge. Insider trading is illegal, as you well know, as a lawyer yourself. But what if you were able to get that inside information where you could make an investment at 40% below wholesale, ensuring you are going to make a profit straight away? So what we're doing is we've created an online course, and if anyone is interested, it'd be great to hear from you, express an interest, and our webinar will start live probably next week or so. If you want to register with us, I don't know how they would do that through you or on through the jewelry.
Go directly to you. Yeah,
go through. If you connect through us on the Facebook page, we have the Jewelry Doctor at Sakakini. And connect us if you're interested, and we will send you an invitation to our webinar, and you can learn more on how to buy successfully, and I mean successfully buy and sell gold and silver.
So these courses run weekly?
These courses will, yeah, they will run, they'll run yeah, weekly, every day, whenever you want, you just sign in, get into it, and then off you go. You're up and running. And then the other course we're doing, we're creating the Diamond Academy, within the Diamond Academy, is obviously how to buy and sell diamonds for pleasure and profit. And we will be coming out in the near future, a course on, for the youngsters, for people who are looking at wanting to get into the jewelry trade, into to become jewelers or learn how to go, you know, how to get a job in a jeweler's. Because, you know, we work in a very closed door infrastructure as jewelers. Mm. And get somebody to bring on board, you're looking at about 5 years training, worth of training, to be able to be proficient in working in the jewelers. But if you've done one of our courses, you will, in fact, probably put you miles ahead of anyone who without any experience. And we will be giving you all the basic knowledge that you would need to get a job straight away. So, you know, it'd be great for school leavers or somebody who's genuinely had a passion or wanting to work in a jeweler's at some stage. So we're going very much educational.
So that's good. I mean, that's obviously part of the diversification, isn't it? Obviously, with lockdown, fantastic. Really, really good. Mm. I hear that you're very popular with speaking engagements. Tell me a bit more about that. What's that about?
Well, when we started, gosh, this would have been about 10 years ago, we started promoting our own business, and we were teaching people how to buy diamonds. And I would do some speak engagements in the shop where we would teach people, you know, the basics of what's a good, bad, and the ugly.
I've seen them. They're brilliant.
Yeah.
And, Facebook Live.
Yeah. And I've done a few, interviews and stuff. One was in Singapore, which got picked up quite well on YouTube, there are so many pitfalls and mines to fall down to and when buying a diamond. So I was doing speaking of the engagements there, and then we were, I was doubling up with other companies. I was invited to speak at Denby's Winery, where they were talking about sparkling wines, and I was talking about sparkling diamonds. I have done talks for, the last one was the National Women's Registrar for 150 ladies. Where I taught 150 ladies all about diamonds for their diamond anniversary. That was a good event. And I did the Probus meetings and WI, and I think we also did the Ladies That Lunch at South Lodge. That was a very good event. So yeah, I'm asked to speak all over, and the great thing is I get paid for doing it too. So what great way of doing it, getting paid for something you're passionate about. But with that, it obviously gave me credibility within my industry, and also helped us become award winners.
I know you're a fantastic speaker, Dominic. So, pandemic. So, future. How do you see the future holding out? What do you see?
To be honest, Alex, it's a really difficult one. I mean, right now, I think our problems haven't even started yet. I think until the lockdown is over, a lot of people are talking about opening up in June, the first week in June. Personally, I can't see it happening. I think my family don't want me to open up, you know, because I'm one of those people who are on the registered letter from the doctor saying, you can't work, you've got to be self-isolating for the 3-month period. But, we're not in a hurry to open up. But, you know, the government have done great with the furloughs. But I think the minute we open up, that is when the problems will start. For us, we are luxury goods. And I don't think the footfall is going to be there. The public aren't going to be confident enough to come out and shop. I can't see it happening till Christmas, you know, business picking up until Christmas, because in retail, in our business, is you have one bad month, it will take 3 months to catch up. Now, last year we had Brexit, and I have to say Brexit killed and hurt a lot of retail industry, retailers. And now we have COVID-19, which should be double the amount of pain that Brexit caused. Fortunately enough, we were, you know, given grants from the government and the councils, but it's still not going to be enough. We were, you know, able, our businesses were able to take out bank loans at low interest rates. But when's it going to change? Christmas? Put it this way, if we don't survive till Christmas, I reckon after that there's a big, strong possibility that the doors will be closing. Hence why we are moving educational wise, and, you know, moving outside. Online jewelry at the moment for high end stuff is not very, you know, it's not very popular. People like to pick it, choose it, wear it, try it out, kick the tires, so to speak, and before they decide they want to buy it. So when does the future hold COVID-19? I don't know. You know, it could well be we'll come through it stronger. We've gone through two recessions and now COVID-19. So, you know, I don't know. It's only the people, what can I say? Only the people of Horsham can tell, because I've got this saying, SOS, and I think we'll call it out, called Save Our Shops. And, you know, if we can all pull together as a community and a community of retailers, I mean, anyone who wants to shop with me, I will support you if you support me. If you want to come shop with me, I will give you, you've heard it from here today, a 30% discount to encourage you to come shop with me. Because I want your business. And let's face it, if you still love the woman you're with after you've been locked down with together after 3 months, why don't you buy her a ring, eh?
Fantastic.
I mean, you got to give her an eternity ring, because it has been an eternity you've been locked down together with. Or, you know, if you, this is a great opportunity for you guys out there. If you decide that you still love her and you haven't stuck a ring on her finger, do you know what? Give us a shout and I'll tell you, I'll guarantee, I promise you, I'll give you a bloody good deal on a ring, give you a good price on a diamond. And, you know, we'll give you 30% off of any retail prices. And, let's face it, those of you who've got weddings planned, and I know there's a shitload of weddings out there that have probably cancelled or been postponed. That's the word, postponed. So a lot of you probably haven't actually gone out there and found the wedding rings yet, have you? So I tell you what, come down to me, and what you do is buy one wedding ring, and the second one is half price. And that's not for the second marriage, right? That's takes two to get married, so the cheaper of the two wedding rings will be at half price. What more can I say? You know, everything that we do, we make to order. I've got an army of people sitting in their workshop waiting to work, waiting for work. And we can sort of, you know, do the best job for everyone. But yeah, it's about Horsham, you know, we do need you. And for your support, or anyone in the surrounding areas, Horsham, you know, if you support us, we promise to support you.
Brilliant. And totally true. Has to be a team spirit. The whole town has to come together to survive. So totally right. So finally, Dominic, in closing, how do people get hold of you? Best way to get hold of you.
Okay, guys, get your pen and paper out. Here we go. My phone number is 01-403-250-200. That's 01-403-250-200. Now, that is the number for the shop, which is, guess what? It's on call forward, straight to my mobile. So basically, you are coming directly to me, and don't be calling me at midnight unless you're going to give me your credit card. But yeah, come, you know, give me a shout 9 to 5. I will take all your calls. We have some private clients putting in some orders. Go on our website. Website is sacgems.com. That's SAKGEMS, sacgems.com. And go on the Jewelry Doctor at Sakakini. the Jewellery Doctor at Saka Kini on their Facebook page. And guess what? We've got more reviews, more Google reviews, and more Facebook reviews than any other jewellers in Sussex. So there you go. If we're no good, then don't bother. But you know what? Give us a shout. Give us a go. All I ask for is give me a go.
An amazing reputation, Mr. Saka Kini. It's been a pleasure. Brilliant. Thank you very much. Keep safe.
No worries. And you, Alex?
Brilliant. I absolutely thank Dominic for being on the show. Excellent knowing about his business, what he's doing, how he's diversifying into new areas as well. And I, myself and all my team wish him well in the future. So thank you once again, Dominic, for being on the show.
For more information on our services across Haywards Heath and Mid Sussex, visit our website at mulcairejenkins.co.uk.
This is the Late Night Lawyer Show with your host, Alex Mancini.
It's incredible. I mean, I'll try not to waffle on these shows, but we're 9 weeks down the line. Can you believe that? We have done 9 shows on the Late Night Lawyer. And this is one of the products of the pandemic, because to be honest, pre-pandemic, the show did not exist. And, you know, I truly thank the listeners for constantly, you know, messaging me their feedback and what they'd like to hear on the show. So it's a constant evolving show, and I thank you all for obviously tuning in and allowing me to run this show weekly. So there's a lot of stuff to come. We'll be developing the show, branding it as it comes through, and you know, it's exciting times. It's a real birth of a really good show, which I'm proud of, and I'm sure, you know, there'll be more guest speakers on the show, and we're going to try and get more incredible music on the show too. Just in closing today, I've got quite a lot to say on today's show, but it's incredible how there is really no boundary for distance. I mean, this week I found myself in Mallorca, New York, Boston, and then traveling back to Australia in the space of 24 to 48 hours. Incredible. You know, business networking at its best. Who would have ever thought before the pandemic and before COVID-19 that literally networking across the globe in the space of 24 hours was possible? And it's opened the doors to so many opportunities, not only for myself, but for all my, you know, fellow colleagues that that are listening to the show and, you know, very much know where I'm going with this conversation. So it's phenomenal that there's been this opportunity given to us through technology that allows us to now socialize and network without any boundaries, without any obstacles or distance. It's brilliant. And, you know, I really hope that as a tool, this enhances businesses across the world, and it brings all the networking together for everybody. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the moment has come. Ali Sherlock, we have more material. She has been in touch with Mark Sherlock, and I thank them both for allowing me this opportunity to have her music on my show. I'm going to be playing an excellent track. If you thought last week's track was good, this is brilliant. It's Stay. It's by Ali Sherlock. It's a cover. Everybody, enjoy the track, relax, stay safe, and I'll see you at the weekend for the Weekend Late Night Lawyer. Enjoy. Keep safe, everyone.
All along it was a fever, cold, sweet-hearted believer. Threw my hands in the air, said, show me something. He said, if you dare, come a little closer. Feel like you're getting about you, yeah, it takes me all the way, and I want you to stay. Not much of a life you're living, not just something you take, it's given. Round and around and around and around we go. Oh, now tell me now, tell me now, tell me now you know. Not really sure how to feel about it. There's something in the way you move makes me feel like I can't live without you. Yeah, it takes me all the way, and I want you to stay. You're the broken one, but I'm the only one who needed saving. Cause when you never see the light, it's hard to know which one of us is caving. Not really sure how to feel about it. It's something in the way you move makes me feel like you can't live without you. Yeah, it takes me all.
For more information on our services across Haywards Heath and Mid Sussex, visit our website at mulcairejenkins.co.uk.